Kerbal Space Program, everyone's favorite expensive spacecraft crashing simulator. Also very heavy on the modding scene with, well, a lot of mods. One of the more popular mods is called BD Armory, a mod used for weaponizing your little green friends with military-grade firearms and explosives. And today, I'll be ranking all of these weapons in a tier list, ranked from best shit on the planet to dead rats in my floorboards. Let's begin. Starting off, we have the Browning 50 Cal, an old relic from World Troll 2, an overall okay weapon for ground combat on tanks, but pretty shit in the air. D tier. Next, the Vulcan. Good lightweight minigun used in lots of ground and air combat. It also comes with a hidden version, which is basically standard issue on most jet craft, and very effective. S tier. The zero-point energy field manipulator, or the funny laser, a lightweight alien weapon that uses gravity as a weapon. Something that would make even Isaac Newton cry. Not very effective in Kerbin, but very effective in a vacuum. B tier. The GAU-8 cannon, a half-ton weighing, 7-barrel giant cannon. I don't really see any use in this, because in the ground or the air, it's a giant fucking cannon with the recoil of a Tab G Barrett. I have been told that it's pretty good against tanks, but still, giant fucking cannon. F tier. Next, the GAU-22, a 4-barrel scaled-down version of the GAU-8 previously mentioned. A tier. Now, guns, but they can move. Truly a revolutionary concept. Starting off, we have the 50 cal turret, a dual cannon with low rate of fire but pretty powerful rounds. However, it is very fragile and go down in a couple of shots, and spread is really bad at longer ranges. F tier. Next, we have the Goalkeeper CIWS, but only the standard one because there's not that much difference between the three. Imagine you mix a GAU-8 and a locking radar, then you have one of the most powerful weapons in BD Armory. Trying to fight this thing is like bringing a musket to the Vietnam War. S tier. The Jdam anti-air turret. Very powerful against air targets, which is precisely who you'll be fighting. It has no radar, but still earns a very good place in A tier. Next, the M230 chain gun turret. A single barrel chain gun commonly used on attack helicopters, but since I have no idea how to make those...
God damn it.
I mostly use them as defensive turrets on larger planes or guns on tanks. B tier. Ripped straight off an M1A2 Abrams, we have the M1 Abrams cannon. Delivers powerful tank shells directly into your soul. S tier. Now, the M102,
Howitzer.
A radial-mounted cannon, which is about the same as the M1 Abrams cannon. It has a very low turn range, it is moderately hard to make look good, but if you do, it's a pretty solid weapon. B tier. The Orlikon Millennium cannon. What looks like a tank cannon is actually a time detonation flat cannon. I mostly use this in anti-air build, so this gun earns a very solid place in B tier. The Airborne Laser, a very effective tool for melting Kerbals. At closer ranges, it's a very powerful weapon, as it fires directly at the target instead of just firing a projectile like normal guns. At longer ranges, you do have to be very precise, which I'm not. Maybe it's because my bad gaming chair, I don't know. A tier. Rockets, aren't they fun? In BD Armory, you've got your Hydras, your S-8 comms, and that's really it. They come in rocket pods or turrets that fire unguided explosives. Overall, pretty cool. B tier. Starting off the missile section, we have the AIM 120. The most popular of the missiles, it is a medium-range, radar-guided missile used on almost every anti-air jet. Just lock on with your radar, put the funny circle in the dot, and fire. Very solid weapon. S tier. Next, we have the AIM 9 side... Wait, did you see that? Also a very popular missile, instead of using radar, it uses short-range heat-seeking to find its target. Can be a little bit hard to use because it's a little bit finicky. Still a very cool weapon. B tier. Next, EMP missiles. With a lot of missiles, they probably have an identical EMP version of them. They work the same as the regular missile version, but instead of high explosives, they pack a small EMP warhead doing low structural damage, but at a short range, disabling all electronics. Also, it makes a cool little lightning effect. A tier. Cruise missiles, a tank pilot's worst nightmare. Just use the targeting pod to lock onto your target, send the GPS over your Kerbal's Wi-Fi hotspot, and fire. B tier. The Air-2 Genie rocket, a heat-seeking air-to-air missile. Also, it could do this. Yes, a nuclear warhead, and a shockwave, which I think does EMP damage at closer ranges. Not very effective for air combat, seeing as it disables you and your target, and also, come on, close-range nuclear warhead. But you can blow up the Kerbal Space Center. A tier. The AGM-88 HARM. This missile has an interesting targeting system. Instead of locking onto you using radar, heat-seeking, or GPS, it locks on using the enemy's radar and your radar receiver. Just turn on your radar warning receiver and get in range of an enemy armed with radar, missile, and guns. When you are in range, fire at the funny triangle. It's not very effective against, well, anything, since they will just fire back at you once you get in range. F tier. Next, the PAC-3 surface-to-air missile. A high-speed radar-guided missile, very effective against air targets. Also, you can put 16 of them in this fucking thing. It can be also used as an air-to-air missile as basically a high-speed AIM-120. S tier. The HEK C tier. I have no idea what this does. Starting off the last section, we have the Jdam, a GPS-guided bomb used in bomber planes, very powerful when used in mass numbers. A tier. Next, the MK-82, an unguided bomb with low damage. I don't like this weapon because I find it hard to aim and not very useful. There's also a version with air brakes, which is okay. D tier. The last of this list is the cluster bomb. Launch from the air, multiply into smaller bombs. It even has air brakes. C tier. And that's pretty much everything. If I've forgotten anything, I probably put it in A tier. Anyway, thank you to everybody that made it this far, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you all next time.